concert. It's a bit of both. It's part of a series of evenings that we're going to hold in Union Chapel from the organised by the church here, called Music and Talk. And this is the first. The next one is next week. A week today in the evening, we're having a sort of impromptu event to recognise that we're the imminent departure of the UK from the EU, and we're calling it Union in Europe, an evening of solidarity with music from all different countries in Europe, and a little talk and conversation, particularly from a lawyer who specialises in immigration law in relationship to the EU. So that's that one. And then on the 20th of November, this is all on our website, 20th of November, we'll have a speaker called Jonathan Barclay, who is the co-leader of the Green Party, and we'll have music that fits his presence. So please come along to those. On December the 4th, the performers that you're going to hear tonight, some of them will be performing on December the 4th in the main chapel, which is an event that we're organising with Green Belt. So please have a look out for that. And then on December the 15th in the evening, come early for our annual Christmas Carols by Candlelight. It's all great. So that's the announcements. I've done all the really important things. My name's Vaughan Jones, I'm the minister, that's why I make announcements. And just to say to you that tonight is really the sort of the inaugural performance of Union Chapel Voices. We've just unveiled the name, Union Chapel Voices. That deserves a round of applause. Tonight is especially an attempt to make a contribution to Black History Month, which is a very, very important month in the calendar of this country and across the world. We're very pleased to welcome Crystal Cassie, who is going to give the talk in the music and talk. Crystal is the founder and director of London Africa Gospel Choir, and they performed here last year, Good Friday, and stunned everybody. So it's great to have Crystal back with us. That is all I'm going to say. Please enjoy the evening. Our performers, the names of our performers will all appear on the screen, as if by magic, so you know who everybody is. And we begin. So please enjoy the evening. Thank you.
child, even in the UK, as soon as it can stand up, it can sing, and then it wants to dance. So music is really integral to our life, and music is very healing. So what we want to do tonight is just honour that and enjoy and share with you. And there will be some moments where we can ask you to take part. Maybe a few voices in here that can do so. We look forward to that, and I'm going to introduce you now to Annalisa. Thank you.
Singing a desperate plea for mercy. 'Twas grace that led me through the desert. My name is actually Yelene, this is Crystal. I'm Crystal's daughter, and somehow I'm here. I'm just going to start off by speaking about... thank you for having us. There we go, back on. I'm going to talk a little bit about the team. So the London African Gospel Choir is made up of people from all over Africa and the diaspora. So we've got people from Uganda, we've got members from Kenya, from Ghana, from Congo, from Jamaica, from Rwanda, from Guadeloupe, and then I'm mixed up. So it's very, very well represented. We've got sounds from all over who have really influenced the sound that we make. And that really ties into the kind of music that we do. So just to speak a little bit about gospel music and the history of gospel music as well. Really, gospel is about the message that is being delivered. It's a way of, you know, the sounds, and generally are known as African American sounds, and it's known as being from African American, from the African American churches and the Pentecostal church specifically. But it's a way of speaking, it's a way of communicating, the roots of it, and the beat and the sound that we've heard so beautifully this evening so far, all come from, you know, Africa, really. The tribes and the way that they communicated with drums and beats, and, you know, and then to think as well that when the slaves were allowed to go to church for the little bit of the Bible they were allowed to hear, but they couldn't read, so they'd just repeat the same line over and over and over again, and would be able to speak their message through that, and through that sound, and, you know, then the harmonizations as well. So really it's moved from Africa, it's moved to America, and then the churches in Africa as well, and I think our sound is so influenced by that, because the churches in Africa communicate completely differently. So you have a lot of the music, a lot more dancing. It's not as a cappella as the sound that you get in the African American churches. I don't know if I've said anything yet.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Peter Cassie. I'm the director founder of the London African Gospel Choir. I've been asked tonight to talk about my journey into gospel music. As a young girl, I'm from Guadeloupe, by the way, living in France, born in Paris. I went to a Catholic church and, yeah, was raised in France, etc. My dream was to become a dancer. That's all I wanted, to dance, dance, and dance. So my mom put me in piano, which I hated it, you know. So I did all the things I was supposed to do, play in front of people, etc., etc. And I'm really rubbish at it, by the way. That's it. So my dream, from when I could have a little bit of independence, is to go to dance class. I funded myself by cleaning up and raising some money, and push myself into a group. They didn't want me, but here we go. They have to take me. And I was on tour and dancing across Europe, going everywhere, traveling, etc., touring from the age of 18 to 25. Believe it or not, I'm older than that. And then I had problems with my knee, I had to stop. And I met my husband, my kids came back here in England. I had a long quest of seeking the meaning of life, because for me, it didn't make sense. I was born, I was going to school, working, and my future was kids married, maybe divorce, I didn't, and die. No, it must be something else. It must be more than that to life, you know. So I had a quest of seeking the meaning of life. Is there anything else? So I just asked God. I said, God, if you're here, you can't get me. Because there's a lot of confusion down here, and I don't know which way to go. So my journey led me to church. Not the church I knew as a Catholic child. In that church, it was singing, dancing, jumping, screaming, shouting, preaching. You preach, I answer, clapping. You know, it was just so joyous. And every time I was going back home, I just, you know, uplifted, changed, ready for another week, couldn't wait for the next service. And also, the differences was that in that African church, was a Ugandan church, by the way, when it comes to praise and worship, there is choreography, you know. It's not just singing and dancing. Everybody's doing this, everybody's doing that, and moving to the right, to the left, jumping, one leg, you know. So, I mean, it was just amazing, you know. So being in entertainment industry and knowing about it, I'm saying, why is this beyond four walls? Nobody knows about it. So me, times when we decide to organize concert and bring all this joyful bunch out in the open. And we had our first show, I think the only in Mellishams at London, and it was sold out. It's like if everybody around needed that piece of happiness, believe it or not. So they all came, crammed the place, and we've been going since. So yeah, that's why it's inspiring me. So the singing and dancing, I just want that, to present that to the entire world. And also, what I find is there is lack of network and support for the African that community and diaspora, okay, in terms of trying to do something together. And when we were talking earlier about different nationality, it's so important and it's such a pivotal point, is that we manage to do something together. South African, West African, East African, we manage to do, to create together without killing each other. So it's possible, you know, just about, yeah. And also, what we did is to offer a platform and support for all the members of the creative, you know, side, like the seamstress, the musician, people do jewelry, craft, etc. We try to support each other, because something we need to know as well is most of the black community living in Europe, they support their own family, but most often time they support their family back home. It's not just living here, paying your rent, gas, electricity, etc. But you supporting your family back home. You know, I'm sure many of us receive that phone call, you know, doctor, school fee, uniform. Yeah, so you have to send money back home, and they expect that from you because now you made it in London, you know? So we try to provide that kind of support for everybody. There's so much talent within the church. Great singer, great musician. And the only time they manage to sing or to dance or whatever is on Sunday. So the rest of the week, they don't really use their instrument. Let it be vocal, musician, whatever. So we decided to provide that kind of platform where people can come and sing and bring their friends in the music. And, you know, so we have like guitarists from Congo, bassists from Ghana, the vocals from South Africa, the dancing, etc. So it's really, really rich in culturally. And then also provide a platform of excellence. So we try to do things. We answer phone call, we answer email, we communicate, we use social media, you know, and try also to develop people so that they can excel in their different discipline. Okay, so it is a place for you to be trained, to be used, you know. You understand me? Okay, great. So the London African Gospel Choir is from 6 to 30 people, you know, from all sides of London as well. So members come from west, south, east. We have a singer from Coventry, a trumpetist from Bristol, bassist from Clapton on Sea. So people come from different parts of London and different parts of England as well. And then we meet in London, we rehearse, and then also we tour as well. So here we are. Okay, we're trying to be much about what gospel is about. Okay, it's about joy, it's about love, it's about happiness, it's about the meaning of life. It's about carrying people to out of the darkness and the greenness that's up there. I'm sorry, there's a lot of bad things going wrong right now, you know. So we try to encourage people to lift up their eyes, and we always want to make sure that when they leave, there's so much happiness. So if you look at the review on Facebook, for example, they will say, stop lifting, you should be prescribed by the NHS, you know. you know, people who said terminal cancer patient, he was really down and depressed, and he was clapping, singing, dancing. You know, so it's just about uplifting. And one fruit of the spirit is joy. You know, let's spread some joy. You know, spread some love. Sometimes it's even difficult to spread that love because really some people, you know, they test you. But the joy, well, to be honest, joy, at least joy, you know, do it joyfully. So try to uplift everybody, singing and dancing, and we have great fun. You know, we forget all our problems, argument, backstage, everything is forgotten as long as we are on stage singing and dancing. And I think it's like,
we feed up the
arts. Yeah, that's the name for that. You know, when you catch something?
Contagious.
It's contagious. It's contagious. It's contagious. So that's what we try to bring everywhere, because that's what we need. We need to be uplifted. There's something more in life than Brexit. So you see, also uplifting, inspiring, what energy. Thank you for sharing your talent, etc., etc. A cool choir, yeah? So, yes, it's a cool choir. Yeah? It's called another African Gospel Choir. So, and also what happened is, what really brought us to the scene is the Jazz Cafe asked us to cover the Grace album from Paul Simons, and we just came from Italy, and we're listening, and we were troubled. You know, when you have something really, really, really good, and you're going to try to arrange it without destroying it, because it's such a wonderful album. It's an album that's a testimony of the time, and pivotal again, of what happened in South Africa, the apartheid. So, you know, politically, it's heavy, you know, it's like a big responsibility. You know, so we were faced with this challenge. And because of the influence, members from different parts of Africa, we managed to put it together in our own way, own influence, without destroying the thing. And because we're all about singing and dancing as well, it's really uplifting. So when you come to see our show, for example, it's 2 hours of singing and dancing non-stop. And then a little bit of respite and go again. We don't give you a break whatsoever. It means a lot to us. It means a lot to us because of what happened in South Africa back in those times, you know, in the apartheid, etc. It means a lot to us because for me, for example, singing and dancing heals the soul. In South Africa, when they're sad, they sing. When they're happy, they sing. When they're dying, they sing. Funeral, they sing. You know, they sing all the time. Even like, you know, I never heard them arguing singing. But backstage, you know, in the bus, when we're touring, everybody wants to sleep, and somebody come up with a song. You know, that's the way of communication. The essence of gospel as well, and those songs, they always carry a message of hope, a message of love, of joy, of rebellion. You know, there's always a message behind it, and when you're talking about gospel, it's supposed to be uplifting, supposed to be encouraging, supposed to be delivering, setting you free, you know, removing bondages and blockages, etc., etc. So the gospel music is supposed to carry a message that would bring hope and direction to your life, encouragement. So we didn't want to get rid of that. So you came to see the Christmas album. But before that, you're going to have 30 minutes of pure gospel. So we managed to squeeze that in before. So we do our own support act. So you came to see Grace there, but first of all, you have to go through London African Gospel Choir singing gospel straight. Yeah, but it's been working, and we are really grateful for this opportunity, you know, to present what we do, the way we do it. I don't know if any of you ever seen the choir singing before in Union Chapel? No? Okay. So if we come, are you going to come and see us? Yeah? Okay. So I'm just open to question and answer, if you have any. Otherwise, I'll just keep quiet anyways. Yeah? No? Okay.
Absolutely.
Yeah, all right.
Better be in touch and out of date.
Tossed around wave upon wave, as a ship adrift from its moorings, cradle me so I belong, in whatever land, in whichever place, as a child seeks a mother and a mothering God. Caress me tenderly in my quest for true freedom. Do not abandon me, even if I lay down and moan and weep, even if I am done.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. A long, long way from home.
See, I was waiting in the water.
Sometimes I feel like I'm almost gone.
Euphrates where dawns were young. I built my hut in the Congo, and it lulled me to sleep. I looked upon the Nile and raised the pyramids above it. I heard the singing of the Mississippi when Abe Lincoln went down to Orleans, and I've seen its muddy bosom turn all golden in the sunset. I've known rivers, ancient, dusky rivers. My soul has grown deep.
Sing along.
Down by the riverside, down by the riverside.
all day. The angels are singing, music for the downtrodden, music of strength, defiance, hope. So we dream, struggle, and shall overcome.
Thank you.
fast to dreams, for if dreams die, life is a broken-winged bird that cannot fly. Hold fast to dreams, for when dream go, life is a barren field, frozen like snow.
Thank you.
Fill us with the light of day.